must be having a hard time because now he's been passed by both Sub-Zero and Blaze and has drifted back. I'm sorry, no, that is Dino. There's too many Porsches that look the same out here.
All right, folks, we're currently at 6 minutes and 44 seconds watching Sub-Zero in fourth place in the Ferrari 458 Italia. So River Merc still leads, as you point out, in the Porsche, followed by Connor in the Mosler. This actually feels like a reminiscent of Lobby A, where Solar was the only Ferrari and Connor is the only Mosler.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so I'm focusing on anything in particular that I need to worry about.
Not that I'm seeing. There is a battle for sixth place going on between Blaze and Anakaliga, however you say his gamer tag? Anakaliga. Okay. Excuse me.
You can call him.
But also, you got Ferhelias as he tries to force his way past that Porsche so he can get in on this battle.
Ferhelias, known for being very defensive, but how good is his offense?
Well, it's looking pretty good right now. He's gonna end up slowing Kaliga up a little bit so Blaze can extend the lead over him and keep his sixth position. However, Ferhelias and Kaliga gotta look out for Hunty, who is on the hunt.
No pun intended.
Sorry, had to do it.
No pun intended.
No pun very well intended.
Anyways, as we continue to race on board with Ferhelias trying to catch up to Kaliga, we also see Blaze has slowed down.
Dino's trying his best to get past Nova, who, ironically enough, is having Nova-style lag.
Just on this replay. For days. Alright, so coming down the hangar straight, we have Kaliga drafting off of Blaze, and right behind in tow is Ferhelias. Battle for sixth place, and it looked like Kaliga almost had the pass on Blaze. He's going to try it again coming down, as they're going to hit up Club in just a moment. Blaze is going to hold the inside line, dips over the rumble strip.
Connor is currently still in second and is starting to chase down River Merc, who slides coming out from under the bridge, and Connor is able to catch up to him a lot.
And 740 has gone off the track. This is going to allow his teammate Huntsy to catch right up to him. This is going to be a McLaren battle for 8th place. And 740 has lost the position to Hunty.
I'm going to guess that these Porsches have a lot of acceleration power because coming down to the front straight, River Merc, despite going off the track a little bit, has actually increased his lead over Connor's Mosler.
And Hunty is pulling away from Sim coming down Woodcote. And John Galt, I believe is also the third team member, is in last place. So we see all three McLarens back to back in the back.
Meanwhile, it's an odd pattern of Porsche, Mosler, Porsche, Ferrari, Porsche in the first five positions.
Now, I've never raced with the Mosler to an extent. I never actually drove that car very well. Mm-hmm. It's definitely a vehicle that needs to be tuned.
Yes. There's a lot of vehicles that need to be tuned.
Well, supercars, I suppose. Yeah. I do know for a fact this car is a nightmare in Forza Horizon.
Yeah, it is a bit of a handful. That's why I don't use it.
Well, Team Hard has proven once again that the Mosler can be tamed with the correct setup.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of Team Hard, we still have Nova here holding his own in fourth position, while poor Dino, after his multiple offs, is trying to catch up with him. Literally, we have Nova in a Porsche sandwich right now.
It's a very happy Halloween here, as we see. Mm-hmm. It looked like Nova was about to lose it for a second.
And Anyway, welcome back. Somehow, Ferhelius has won the battle for sixth place and has actually started to pull away from Blaze quite a bit. Gligas also got Hundy still chewing on his tail, while Hundy has still got to fend off from his teammate, SimF40. There seems to be little battle pockets of battles everywhere throughout this race.
And we are trying our best to focus on everyone as best as we can. Which unfortunately doesn't always work out. Ooh, Sub-Zero goes wide, almost going into the hangar straight. This is going to allow Dino Salenzi to catch up right to him.
Meanwhile, we got a Porsche Ferrari Porsche battle up here. As each of these cars keep getting closer as the lap goes on here.
Well, it's right now between Dino and Sub-Zero Nova going out of the hangar straight. Looks like Sub-Zero's having some difficulty with that Ferrari. He's a little loose. Coming down into Club.
The last time I raced Nova in a Ferrari, his lag actually managed to take both me and my teammate out. So.
And who is your unfortunate teammate?
Badger Graveling. That was on a virtual one event a couple months ago.
And I just noticed that Dino Salenzi is telling us that his GT3 is a hybrid. So that means it's an energy efficient car?
I guess. Or it's using that hybrid hyperdrive that the from the Porsche, what is it, the 99 or the 919, the current LMP1 car?
Maybe.
I don't remember. There's too many numbers in Porsche.
All you need to know is that they're Porsche, and that
yes,
we will eventually get to race one outside of Forza. That's not sponsored by Electronic Arts.
EA, please let us have other Porsches.
Still nothing has changed up in front between River Merc and Connor. They are quite a ways ahead of third place. That's the only change that's happened.
But Connor has caught significantly up to River Merc as compared to a couple laps ago.
Update, down on the hangar straight, Sub-Zero Nova has moved into the top three. However, Dino Salenzi is going to challenge him on the straight with teammate Ferhelias in the back. Or, no. Dino Salenzi, Sub-Zero Nova, and Zeltoid.
Ooh. Oh, contact.
Oh, Zeltoid almost took
there
out
goes
his
Nova.
Teammate. Wow, and this is before getting into Club. As we see, oh, looks like Sub-Zero Nova has dropped two positions, exiting out of Club. This is going to be good for the Porsches, as Dino Salenzi is in third. And Ziltoid has gone on to the slippery tarmac. I think that's a good time to separate these two.
Nova's not going to be happy with that. He's going to attack even harder now.
Well, with that little goof up with Ziltoid, this will be a good chance to lock into the draft as Ziltoid slides coming down through the turn. And this is going to give Zero Nova hopefully a chance to pass. Ziltoid's going to go on the defensive. He's going to try to block the inside line to push Sub-Zero Nova off the track. He almost successfully did so.
Nova is really trying everything he can to get around this Porsche. If he's not careful, he's going to end up in sticky grass.
Well, he almost did.
Yeah.
All right, folks, we're down to three laps here at Silverstone. Porsche has dominated the front with a Mosler and a Ferrari 458.
Ooh, towards the back, we have the train of McLarens. They're all going against... his gamertag. What is it?
Well, it's going to be between Blaze and Anon Kalega.
Kalega, thank
Blaze,
you.
Yep, Blaze just got loose going into Maggots. So he's going to drop to 10th place. This is going to allow SimF40 to move into 9th. And now Anon Kalega is going to feel the pressure of the McLaren hype train. Speaking of, McLaren is currently in 7th, 9th, and in last. So this is probably the longest foot-long sandwich you will ever see of cars.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he went back to the front and saw Rivermark bounce his car a little bit as he was going over the curves at Club, I think it was? Yeah. I can't remember all of the turns in Silverstone right now.
And somewhere, someplace, someone is banging their head against the computer desk.
Sorry.
It's okay. I'm the master of butchering turns and gamer tags.
Yep.
Alright, looks like Sub-Zero Nova has passed... No, has not passed yet, but he's made ground up on Ziltoid. Dion Slenzi has pulled away from his teammate. As we continue looking through the field, I think we're going to focus on the back, as Hunty has moved into 7th, with Kaliga in 8th, and Sima 40 in 9th place. And Blaze is about to lose another position in just a moment to John Galt. Not looking very good for the Hatsune Miku liveried Mercedes. Rumor goes wide coming out of Woodcote, and he almost took John Galt with him. I also point out that we are about almost 2 laps away from finishing the race.
Back towards the front, looks like Connor's actually lost a little bit of time in Rivermark. He actually put his car up on the curve going into Club and down through, or yeah, going into Club from Vale. So he lost a bit of time on my screen. Ziltoid, too many exposures. Rivermark is coming down.
Rivermark is currently in first with Connor in second and Dion Slenzi in third, and Ziltoid is still under pressure from Sub-Zero Nova.
Yeah.
He's closing the gap, but he cannot find that opening on him.
Man, these horses are really fast in a straight line. Coming up to Blue Field, Connor was catching up on Rivermark a little bit, but now we're going up through Copes. Riffmerks just pulled his lead out even farther.
And it looks like Sub-Zero Nova's gonna challenge Ziltoid coming down through Woodcote towards the front straight away. The Porsche's gonna have the acceleration, and he makes contact with the Ferrari! Nice recovery there, Sub-Zero, almost making contact with the concrete barrier, almost ending the race for him, with only 2 laps to go. That would have been bad.
That would have been bad. Oh, going towards the back there. Blaze went off, coming up to Maggots, and now he's getting caught up by John Gull as they're going through Beckett's and into Chample Curve.
However, Blaze is starting to recover before he hits the hangar straight in just a moment.
Mm-hmm.
And a battle shaping up between Anon Kaliga and one of the McLarens.
Sim F40, if I'm saying that right.
And Hunty slides on the tarmac.
Ooh, Kaliga broke sooner than 40 thought, and 40 got a little piece of the Porsche's rear bumper.
As we look coming out of Club, but this is not going to slow down Sim F40 off the track. He actually was able to slow down enough to keep his car on the road.
Mm-hmm. Having a Porsche in the way helps with that.
Yes, it does. Porsche, thank you.
Yes.
All right, folks, we're coming down to the white flag momentarily. See where River Merc is currently. Oh, he's right on Woodcott, so white flag will be out for Rivermark with Connor in second place. Unfortunately, these two aren't really going at it due to the distance, so we're going to focus back towards the middle of the field.
Zero. Nova goes off on Woodcott, and now he's even farther behind. Which Porsche is that? Ziltoid.
Yeah, Ziltoid.
They were rumored to close going through Woodfield in primary, but he's pulled out. Ziltoid's pulled out a little bit of a lead on Nova. Porsche Hilly has in sixth, has nobody around him. He's got his own little pocket of clean air here.
And John Gold still putting the pressure on Blaze coming down through turn one. It looks like, I think it's safe to say we're going to focus back on Rivermark. Don't really see much else taking place. See, exits out of club with Connor right behind.
And Nova's pushing his car too hard now. He's been putting up on curves the last couple of turns, so even if he's going to end up slowing himself down. Virgilius isn't that far behind him, but he keeps making mistakes. Virgilius is probably going to take his position from him.
He has been pushing a good portion of the race. I think he's done all he can.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Porsche makes up for what happened last at the Nürburgring Grand Prix and is going to be taking Europe by storm here at the United Kingdom. Checker flag is going to be in the air as he comes out of Woodcott, and the winner of race one for Lobby B is going to go to Rivermark in a Porsche with Connor in the Mosler for Team Hard in second place. In third, it will be the second of the Porsches, Dino Salenzi. And a quick update with 4th, 5th, and 6th, we see Ziltoid, the third team member in the Porsche, with Sub-Zero Nova right behind, still losing ground as he knocks over a cone. And in 6th will be the Lambo of Virgilius. Still looking in the back, it looks like we have Hunty, the first of the McLarens, with an Onkeliga, the last of the Porsches in 8th. 9th is going to be Sim F40, the second McLaren. 10th is going to be Blaze in the Merc, locking his brakes up pretty heavy. Okay, we see the end of the replay. Alright, so that actually concludes our back-to-back simulcast here of Lobby B for World GT. Thank you very much, Ben, for joining us, and unfortunately we're going to have to end it here. This Sunday will be